Welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. This week we're starting out with some craft cardstock. It's just cut and folded to a standard size card, so it's 5.5 by 4.25. And we're going to do a lot of stamping today, but we're going to do some masking with it as well. I've got these 4 strips of just like computer paper, just printer paper, and they're 1/4 inch wide each. And I'm actually going to apply them to the edges of the card using some removable adhesive. And they're going to be longer than the card. And I did that so that I would have a little bit of a tail to work with, so I could, you know, I'd be able to have the edge. Okay, and I also have this piece right here that, actually, is that the right one? No, that's not the right one. This is the right one. I've got this piece here that I'm going to put over, you know, just lower than center on the card. Okay, I'm just going to press that down. Okay, now we're going to do a background stamp. And it seems silly to mask off almost the entire card just to use this background stamp. But I wanted to leave some marks. You know, I want it to be a definite area that's marked off. And the stamp I'm using today is the Fabric Design Stamp. I'm pretty sure it's the Fabric Design Stamp. Let's see here. Large Fabric Design. It's from Hero Arts. It's one of their cling stamps, and it's one of their new ones. It hasn't been out too long. I'm going to use some Crumb Cake ink from Stampin' Up. And this craft color, Stampin' Up sells it under the name of Crumb Cake, so this ink goes along with it. It's supposed to be the same color, so it's really great for tone-on-tone stamping. I'm going to go ahead and ink this up. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and place this down onto the card. And I'm going to get a brayer. Just rolling over. You can use your hands to do this too. You don't have to have a brayer. But this just really evenly gets that card pressed down onto the stamp. Okay, so you can see that design there, really pretty. Okay, now I can pull all the masking off. Lovely. All right, now I've got a stamp from American Crafts. This is from the One and Only stamp set, and I used this stamp on a Family Friday card a couple weeks ago, but I'm going to use this one right here. I've already got it on the block. And I've already taken a sanding block and just lightly sanded off the very itty-bitty top surface of this stamp. That's because I'm going to be using some markers. And it's just going to make it a whole lot easier to have the stamp not kind of beat up on, or the ink to not beat up on the stamp. Some clear stamps have a really slick surface, and so it's hard to use with some more water-based or dye-based inks. So this is just an easy way to get around that problem. And it doesn't really harm the stamp. It should be just fine. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and I'm doing the top and bottom of the stamp in brown. So I'm going to go ahead and just start applying that. Okay, and now onto the red. Okay, I'm going to breathe on the stamp. Then I'm going to stamp it. Beautiful. All right, the last thing I'm going to do to finish off this card is to do some white stitching. And I'm going to do kind of like a grid pattern. I'm going to do all the way, all the corners, or all the sides, and then I'm going to do around these sections that I created with masking too. Okay, so there's the card for this week. Really different card for me, very basic. Well, that's not new for me, but really basic, minimal stamping, a little bit of technique with masking, and also the straight to stamp inking with the marker. So hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.